Hey fam, what's up? What's good? Yeah, it's a little unusually bright in here, isn't it? Yeah, that's because I'm in my lighting class now, so we have to use our light kit. And I brought two of the three lights in my room to just see what it looks like here. But yeah, anyway, this is, like the title says, my thoughts on the news coming out of the gathering. First of all, the drugs, the overdoses, and all that shit, the was going down. I disagree with the person who said that, we don't need those juggalos who died and stuff because, well, first of all, I think the reason why the police and feds are getting involved this time is because there's a new drug, and apparently it's some really bad shit because like 10 people have overdosed on it. And I mean, I don't necessarily think every single person who overdoses is a bad person. I mean, yeah, there are the hardcore druggalos out there, but some of them could be decent people who just made a bad decision to try something new and it did not work out very well for them. So, anyway, yeah, drugs are bad. Moving on. ICP's big news is, of course, not too big. I'm glad to see that someone on Carnival Spirits agrees with me that the elite Juggalo's comment that Violent J made is kind of a shitty thing to say, and what he said was that everyone there at the gathering are the elite Juggalos, and I guess just better than everyone else. And this whole Juggalo world is supposed to be based on equality and acceptance, and maybe that's just Twisted's point of view because they're the ones that I've heard say that it's not how much merch you have or how long you've been down. Because there's a lot of true down-ass juggalos that can't make it to the gathering because they have too many responsibilities or they simply can't afford it. Now, if I really wanted to go, yes, I could have bought myself a ticket. If I could have bummed a ride, I could have bought the $175 ticket. But yeah, that would screw over my cats and my grandmother because I have to take care of her. She's gone through colon cancer. I gotta take her to appointments. I have school. I have work to do. And there's just no way I can get away for a week anymore. Things have changed since the first couple of years that I went. Back then she was a lot healthier and could take care of herself and could take care of the cats. And now she's not able to. So it's up to me to be here. So anyway, my point is that there's also a lot of asshole juggalos who hate on everyone else and aren't down with the family concept that go to the gathering. And there's also those people that go to the gathering that aren't juggalos at all and just go for what the fuck ever reason. And there's no way that they're more of a juggalo than those of us who are truly down. So, yeah, it bugged me a bit, and I thought, well, maybe I'm overreacting. Maybe he was just trying to hype the crowd or something. But I'm glad to see that there are other people out there that agree that that's kind of a shitty comment. But anyway, no hate, not judging, just saying. Weird smell. I hope it's not that. Anyway, since Blaze is officially off of Psychopathic, I hope he works with Twisted more and releases future albums under Twisted's company or label if they start one, but I suppose they can just run as an LLC like they are now. I don't see why it has to be a label. And I'm 50-50 on Boondox's return to Psychopathic because I'm glad that I'll get to hear a new album from him at some point. Although it's kind of sad to know that they don't exactly get paid for their sales on Psychopathic. And I'm also disappointed to hear that he did make an album while he was away, but the producer of that album is a shady motherfucker who won't give it to him. So all of that freshness that we know and love from Boondocks, or at least I know and love from Boondocks, is lost forever. And again, I mean, it just sucks to see people that you love and respect and look up to not getting the pay or recognition for their work that they deserve. And by that I just strictly mean the fact that, he took the time to write and record stuff while he was away and we'll never get to hear it. So that's my two cents on everything we've heard. So until next time, peace out, fam. Whoop, whoop.